up of Exkiernan. There's Johnston to Cooper. Good run by Cooper and Latchford there. Tommy Burns. Bobby Lennox was spotting on the outside. Jackson. And now Dawson. Cooper. I think they're, of all the options in any situation, I think players are going to be extremely cautious. First goal is absolutely vital. No whistle on that one, and McGarvey. McLeod took it well. Lennox is wide. Again by Provin. Great tackle by Forsyth, and now it's Sandy Jardine. Cooper. The running of Cooper and Provin have been a delight to watch. It's Russell that's wide here. Good turn inside McLean. Here's Cooper with a chance. And he squandered it. The finish simply wasn't disciplined enough. Beautifully set up again. He had all the time in the world, nothing to play coming into. Forced him to go to that left-hand post. There's McLean again. Covering. Fly with a smart looking little skip somehow. Cowling. Powerful clearance by McCloy again, but to no avail. Stevens could get to that. Garvey. Good position, oof. Beside it, nobody was putting it. Lennox. Here's McCloy committed and did well. And Tom Forsyth put his defence under pressure. And once again, McCloy played excellently. Both goalkeepers have been in the top of the form. That's meant for Roy Aiken. Graves making straight for the referee. And everybody in the Celtic dugout is right out. McLean, great ball by McLean. And too wide. I think it's McCluskey who is down. Referee refusing to stop the play. It goes on, and here is Cooper. McLean wants to go wide. Cooper squandering that. Ball put out of play, and the referee is having absolutely nothing of the injury down there. Indeed, the Celtic physiotherapist has come on. And, well, here we are, Aiken pushing that in. And appeals that that was a penalty kick. There's got to be a booking, by the way. McGarvey has said something. And it's all getting very tense now. I think the players realise that just the slightest break, an accidental ball, lucky spin, lucky bounce, might just win this cup final. So McGarvey has been booked and can't believe it. George Matthew, do you think it might get a bit ragged?
No, I don't think so. That was just one of these things, the defenders thinking as defensively as they possibly could in the box. I don't think it will get very ragged at all. It's been fought at a very, very hard and clean battle. It's been marvellous. It's been a marvellous game, Archie.
Offside. George Johnson, Conroy's there. Russell now. Russell could get a shot in and it's a corner kick. Rangers with simply more in this extra time period into which we have gone 6 minutes. Well, Bartle coming on there and as Bertie suggested, this game will still go on hard but fair. McLean with it. Corner kick given and Aiken. And Ratchford rightly getting Aiken right out of it. The referee got to have a word with Aiken for complaining about that. Dave Cooper to take it. There's Jackson. Well, Colin Jackson was appealing away and that ball broke to him. Classic lesson on how to get on with the play. Well, that's a good ball by McLeod. Jackson tackling well. And Rangers have set themselves up at the tail end of the game and at the beginning of this half for some good chances. Robin again. Free kick. Tommy Burns quickly with it. Lennox might want to go on the outside. It's a loose ball. There's Forsyth equally loose with that. Robin now. Here's Smith. And on the return. Pushes it too far ahead. His control not as good as it should have been. McGray. On the overlap. Oh, and it's all getting in a tangle here with Stevens and Mugabe. And there's going to be a booking here. Stevens being booked in that tangle with Mugabe. Well, Bertie, I hope you're right. I just think that one or two players are getting a wee bit tense up there.
Yeah, I'd say that, but that was just tiredness, both trying to get up, Archie. That wasn't a bad tackling anyway.
So, free kick in any case to Celtic. Putting that down exactly. Robin picking it up. Free kick given again. Even though Robin had broken free. Tommy Burns. Cloud. And Jackson. Ooh, just away in a real tangle. And Rangers are finding it difficult to clear the lines. Now, Cooper. Here's Dawson. To McLean. Way wide, Sandy Jardine walking in there and walking well. Johnston can't turn it round properly. Not taken on by that attention. Stevens, better header that time. 5 minutes left of the first half of extra time. understanding that. Instead, I think letting him know exactly what he feels about him. Here's Cooper, turns well again. Shielding the ball, can't get away with it. Aiken was covering it. There's a bit of crap there for David Cooper as Aiken took that and gets it on the return. Sneddon. Bobby Russell almost getting away with it. And Cooley again. Conroy, who's been immaculate throughout this game. And the dugouts, respective dugouts, must be feeling the pressure now. McLean couldn't quite get to it. Free kick, late tackle there. Quite accidental though. Allen's going on the outside and is stopped. Free kick. McGray, clever one by McGray. McGarvey turns well on it. Stevens with him. Still McGarvey. Keep it out to Throbin. McLeod, and there's Jackson. Russell just getting the touch. Still Celtic though. Oh, and Lennox took his eye right round it. You could see what was happening to him. He's going to just try and touch it round as Sneddon came. Cooper. Right to McLean. Clean as a whistle. Danny McGrain, and that's Jardin on the outside. Here's Jardin. A good-looking ball coming up there. McLean. Now Russell. Dawson. Here's McLean, and if Johnston watched it, go past. Johnston watched that, go past the post. Again, Cooper, accurate with his. Now keep your eye on Johnston, number 9. He looked at it, and it was too late for him. They couldn't believe it. Not good to Celtic defence, I may say. Well, Jock, that goes down as a clear-cut chance for Rangers.
And that's the best chance of having the game. It's not like Johnston to look at the ball there, but he's done that and missed the chance, so that's that one over. But there's crap coming into the game now, and it's a tremendous game. An indication of the pace and the fire that's been played in this game is that the Rangers and Celtic players are forming the crap. This, I don't think, has ever happened before.
Well, there we are, two players down at the moment, Davey Probyn and Gregor Stevens. Mixture of cramp and incipient exhaustion. Alec Buller, who is known to have staying power, limbering up on the sidelines. It has been a great game, there is no two ways about that. A free kick. Hard tackle by Jackson. Roy Aikens there. Just 15 seconds away from the first period. And that is another push. Free kick to Celtic. With it. We're into injury time in this first 15 minutes. There goes Dawson. and the half-time whistle goes, and McCluskey went down again. Loud shouts for a penalty kick. There you see him now, Billy McNeil, looking anxiously towards that. I think he is probably perturbed by that decision, and that's the scoreline as we hand you almost limply back up to the box. And John Wallace and Bertie Alder there. Firstly, Bertie, players are suffering fatigue a bit out there, so a goal might conceivably come more by mistake than anything else.
That's right. Well, that was a typical mistake. You know, Jackson committing himself there in the box. But the thing is, Archie, the game has been played at such a pace. There have been no defensive thoughts at all. It's been a marvellous attacking game. And in the second half, in the extra time there, we could have had two or three goals, couldn't we? And that's been the pattern we play since the game started.
So we go into this last 15 minutes, the last period of extra time. McClay. Jordan's looking for it and gets it. Conroy's with them, and Rangers will settle for that corner kick. So Tommy McLean, who has come on and played an extremely significant role for Rangers, adding a lot of guile to the play. There's Jackson. Great save by Latchford again. Bobby Russell, and Cooper was going for that at the same time. Stevens taking no chances. He's attempted to mark McGarvey closely. He's made one or two blunders though in defence. It's McGarvey away in the far side. On a given. McGarvey working very hard in the far side. Into the penalty area they go again. By Dawson, there's Sneddon, Tom Forsyth, still not clear, Danny McGrain, oh that's a goal! McCluskey got the touch from that shot, there was a deflection! with a great chance and he's missed it. Oh, he could have put the issue beyond that. Rangers ripped apart there. They had pushed everybody forward and Burns took it away to the side. Now Jardine. And it goes to Smith. Smith just getting into a tangle. And I think will be a goal kick. The Celtic supporters jubilant about that. The impassive Rangers support at the other end. Celtic really have the dander up now. That's McCloy's. After his style. Ah, here's McCloy. John wants it and gets it. Dawson, Bobby Russell, but a spin in that ball and away by McLeod. Russell was slow with it. Here's McCluskey. Rangers are so wide open now. They push players forward. Now McCluskey. Danny McGrain coming up, and McGrain can't quite get it, and then McCloy done brilliantly. And here's Russell to Jardine. Way to McLean. Smith's on the outside. There's McLean and there's Smith. Returns into trouble. Rangers have pushed everybody forward. Tommy McLean to take it. Licking one and that's right. Quite superb in the air. And Latchford will no doubt take his time about this. And so will the grain. Waving play on, that's not a good kick out. There's Stevens to McLean and the way by Aiken. And Rangers are putting on Alec Miller. Rangers are going to bring on Miller. Play still going on though. Here's Dawson. Good play by Dawson. Al Cooper. Celtic tightened up in defence. The way towards Lennox. McGarvey, the ball is out of play. And Alec Miller is on. Tom Forsyth is coming off. The Rangers as Tom Forsyth comes off. Here's Russell. Now Jardine with only 6 minutes left. Here's Smith. Way behind again and he has laboured these chances on the left, Smith. He's had the opportunity to get the ball over quickly. Goal kick. And there's a Celtic support celebrating, although six, five and a half minutes. McCluskey. In comes Dawson. Cooper. A great tackle by Lennox. And that will be out of play. Downfield and straight to Latchford. We're way out of that that trouble area, and the referee judges that to be a free kick. Free kick to Celtic. A free kick, I think. A bit of hostility developing between these two, but the referee quickly across. We have 4 minutes left. Rangers fighting on. One behind. Beautifully taken down by Lennox, and again, trying to find Bunge, and he does. Miller coming over, Bunge is there. Good looking ball, the Rangers defence, wide open. Here's a great chance for Proven, and Lennox underneath it. Corner kick. I think Gordon Smith has crabbed away the far side. Well, at this stage, Jock, it looks as if Celtic have this game won.
Well, the game's not finished yet, because these two teams don't know how to lie down. The game's not over yet. I think there's still one or two more chances to come out of the game yet.
And certainly the first chance now to Celtic from this corner kick. Alex wanting the Rangers players to get back. Dawson. Robin supporting. That'll be another corner. Corner to Celtic. Only a couple of minutes left. And Celtic will be quite content to do this for the next couple of minutes. Rangers in a very tight spot. Physically, and the analogy of them being in this situation with 2 minutes left, goal down, and that's Gregor Stevens. Again, Rangers can't get possession. Danny McGrain. And he'll take the ball right to the corner. And the referee has given a free kick. Holding on to it. Tommy Burns. We're playing out the last minute. Celtic are one up. Derek Johnson trying to get a hold of that, couldn't quite get it. There's Russell, and slid away by Danny McGrain. Andy Jordan to take this throw. Here's Cooper. Jordan. Free kick, I think, two Rangers. We have 20 seconds left. Celtic leading by 1-0. Tommy McLean with it. And there's a bit of hooking by the goalkeeper, and I think he's got Conroy around the neck. Won't object to that. And there goes the final whistle. Celtic have won the Scottish Cup for the 26th time. Onto the field goes Billy McNeil to congratulate the
one of the heroes.
In an extra time that must have drained everybody physically and mentally, the Celtic players celebrating a notable victory. John Doyle, who was substituted, came on there. And there we are, the triumphant Celtic team. It was a marvellous game. The Celtic supporters at this end quite jubilant. The Rangers support drifting away, and there is captain and manager in an embrace that sums the whole occasion up. What a remarkable game that could have gone either way for so long in this match. But Celtic took the ball in the back of the net, and that was a vital difference between the teams. And I've just been told that the man of the match is Danny McGrane of Celtic. These Celtic supporters, I'm sure, have found it a hard afternoon, but now it's all been worth it. Sporting handshakes there is Danny McGrane, the man of the match, goes up to get the Scottish Cup. And there's an invasion of Celtic supporters. They've come right across. They're spilling right onto the pitch. And indeed, Rangers supporters are coming on now. And where are the police? For heaven's sake, where are the police? The very thing that all the precautions that were supposed to have been established in this match to prevent this have really got it. Look at this. And here's Dougie Donovan with Danny McGrane.
Was it difficult to lift yourself after the disappointment of losing the league?
Not really, no. I think it's one of the
man of the match, go and play to cup. Danny, well done.
Well, there's the Scottish Cup now, waiting for the Celtic captain. And the field is now covered with supporters. The Celtic supporters still coming on. And there's Danny McGrane about to get the Scottish Cup. Down the terrace and on. support came on, the other followed, and we had a charge from one end of the ground to the other, and then the reverse, and here's Derek Johnston. The losing captain, but what a remarkable fight Rangers made of this. Congratulations to Celtic on winning this trophy. They fought well throughout. They had that handicap of the two central defenders not playing in this match. Conroy played magnificently in the breach. But I'm not going to hide my feelings about this. This is ridiculous that this should have happened at the Scottish Cup final. So much for Francis on the ground. And here's another charge. Here's another charge.
Scenes of violence we've seen here at Hampden Park. Bottles, cans and missiles being thrown, and it's a pitch battle out there. Police in the middle of it are nearly powerless to try and prevent this happening. The fans have just leaped over the fences and now into a pitch battle. There's senior policemen out there trying to see how they can possibly stop this. Missiles, here come the mounted police to stop this, to try to stop it. This really is a shocking scene. Little fans obviously terrified, sitting in the goal mouth there, wondering precisely what is happening. Is this football? Is it sport? It certainly looks like outright war here. Look at that scene, shocking scene at Hampden Park. What should have been a grand finale finish. Here we go again, the Celtic fans this time are charging at the Rangers fans. The police horsemen have drawn their truncheons and are battling into the Celtic fans. This is quite an extraordinary scene. Rarely has anything like this ever been seen. There's a police woman with a bat on her shoulder. The police totally nonplussed. They obviously had to bring the mounted police in there to try to get the fans back into their places. The trouble escalated so suddenly. The process had been presented, the winner's medal has been given to Celtic, and then this happened. Now look at that lineup again of these fans ready to have another go at the Celtic end of the pitch. Mounted policemen still riding around there, trying to calm things down, and still the bottles, missiles, sticks, anything these fans can get a hold of. Now the police are charging at the Rangers fans, and they're in hot retreat. Well, this really is an astonishing scene, and what a way to end the cup final. Mounted policemen and one horse lady there having to duck away from cans and missiles which are being hurled at them, and one of the policemen loses his hat, and one of them in fact is injured. He's been injured. I think one of the police horses bumped into that foot policeman, and now he's lying there getting attention from some of his colleagues. Here's more police horses coming on to give assistance. Now we have eight of them all together, all of them with their long batons drawn. Policemen on foot lining up in the middle of the field to try finally to put an end to this shocking trouble. This is possibly the worst incident I have seen in a football field in 25 years of world travels. I was in Barcelona when fans were in trouble there, Newcastle, Sunderland. I was in Argentina, in trouble erupted, but nothing as undignified, nothing as stupid, nothing as violent as this. Policemen and foot trying to herd the supporters back in to the terraces to try once and for all to stop this horrific trouble. One of the goal area, the left-hand side of the field, looks like a casualty station. Fans sitting in there being attended by ambulance men and clearly trying to shield themselves from the missiles which are being hurled or have been hurled from the terraces. Celtic have won 1-0, but surely this will take a lot of the pleasure out of that victory. Well, some order seems to have been restored. The policeman encouraging, coaxing and pushing the fans back in to the terraces. Celtic 1-0 winners of the Scottish Cup final here at Hampden, but in the end, was it a victory for the Thugs? What a sad thing it would be if this were to be so. There's the lineup of police horses, 8 of them, facing the fans and saying, stay where you are. Well, there it is, the Scottish Cup final, won 1-0 by Celtic, the goal scored by George McCluskey. With that, from Hampden Park, back again to Upper Montgomery.